It's a book unlike any other book that I've ever read. And I think that many people who come to this book think, you know, it's something like, it's like they found a kind of prophecy, because it's such a beautiful and truthful piece of literature, and one totally unlike, again, anything else that I can think of. The title, it sells itself, right? So it is a provocative title, and it's, you know, the book deals with these questions of identity in a very direct way. And when Larry Mitchell was writing this, at first he thought that he was writing a children's book for children who had parents who wanted to teach their children another history, so a history that wasn't the one that we received in our textbooks. In the end, he wasn't writing a children's book nor a history really, but he was writing a fantasy, and it was a fantasy for adults. Philip Venable's music, it's for me, what I love about it is that it always has this very beautiful heart beating at the center of it, but at the same time, it's quite adventurous in the way that he's looking to use music, so not in a sort of as a placeholder or as a given, but he's looking for, you know, the role of music, and oftentimes the role of the musician in music. He was a violinist training as a musician, and I, myself coming, you know, also from being a performer, I think both of us approach things from that standpoint of what is it to, you know, stand on a stage and deliver something. And so I think a lot of our work comes from that. The other things I love about Phil's music is that it draws from such a wide range of histories and repertoires, and always feels like it's drawing on older ideas, but also is pushing past those and finding new territory. I think what feels exciting about the piece about faggots and their friends is that the queerness is really up front, and also the celebration of the joy of queerness, the joy of sex. All of these things are dealt with in very open ways, and I think queerness has been dealt with, especially in the last century, by composers like Britten, and, you know, we've had queer operas in a way, but none, I guess, that I can think of that present queer topics in such a positive. Our piece, which is really like music theater, it comes very much from the book, so it is a clear retelling of the book, and the language of the book is written almost it's like a children's bedtime story. So it has a kind of musicality to it, and it has this fantasy in it, and we wanted to sort of match that fantasy. So we have a stage full of 15 actors, singers, and musicians, and they form an ensemble. And this ensemble they're all storytellers, and this ensemble of 15 will tell you this bedtime story.